Control Center preparing mission SCFCCLA 2020 for blastoff. Do you copy mission?
I have a copy.
Okay, mission SCFCCLA 2020. In T-minus 2 minutes, launch will be progressing. We need to make a final rundown of all systems of operation before shuttle is cleared for takeoff.
Copy that, Control. The FCCLA planning process will help begin our final check of all systems.
Beginning check. Have you identified any concerns for this mission?
That's affirmative, Control. We feel there's a lack of understanding in our community about SCFCCLA 2020's mission and its purpose, as well as a lack of leadership in our school.
Concern noted. A goal for the mission has been set. Knowledge of the purpose of our mission will be made clear by the explorations and performances planned and carried out in the Smith County Galaxy.
That's a go, Control. We have staged a plan for all citizens of Smith County.
That's a copy. The plan for this performance is to throttle up until we reach full speed on performances and activities in the school and community.
This will take place in July 2019 through May 2020. Do you have a copy, Control?
That's a copy. Why is the staging of this mission so important?
The mission was planned to promote the family, career, and community leaders of America and its value to our community and school. Control, how do we know that there will be no unexpected errors on this mission?
All school and community activities have been planned and are ready for liftoff. We are now at T-minus 3 seconds and counting.
3, 2, 1, blastoff.
Hi, I'm Kendra Maidu, the command pilot.
And I'm Lizzie Fortler, the mission specialist. And we would like to share with you how we launched the SCFCCLA 2019-2020 mission. Shortly after liftoff, our 12-member flight crew met for a planning meeting. At this time, we set goals for our organization and planned the year's up-and-coming events. During this time, we vowed to increase active membership throughout our flight.
Our first plan of action was to increase our membership so that we had many members to assist us with our mission. We voted to get all potential crew members together in late August for an out-of-this-world bonfire. We had a stellar turnout and many pledged to join.
Soon into our flight, we had an FCCLA rush week from September 9th through the 13th. We dressed up in out-of-this-world outfits, performed good deeds, filled our time capsule slips, and spread awareness of FCCLA by wearing red.
We held a membership breakfast to finalize the numbers, which resulted in 50 qualifying members and 12 commanding officers who will use their special skills to make our flight a success.
Several of our newly found commanding team members attended Take AIM in Manhattan, Kansas, to develop their leadership skills through a series of breakout sessions.
To fuel ourselves on the district level, 21 members attended the Fall Leadership Conference. We participated in breakout sessions and enjoyed a good motivational speaker, and we celebrated FCCLA's 75th birthday with ice cream.
Now that the mission team is formed, it was our captain's job to schedule monthly chapter meetings. The captain scheduled 5 monthly meetings, and our head mission control team worked hard to lead us to an unknown galaxy. They encourage members to participate in many fundraising and community service activities.
Every month we passed around sign-up sheets for current events and kept our members up to date with a bulletin board posted in our FCS room. Members are encouraged to check the bulletin board frequently for sign-up sheets and new information.
Our active members have received much recognition. At the District B Fall Leadership Conference, our mission control team was recognized for its involvement. We also received the Active Chapter Award, and much recognition was given with thank you notes for some of the more prominent scenes in the community related to the hospital fundraiser and other services we provide.
We continued recognizing a Member of the Month based off of the Space Cadets' involvement in our mission, especially community service, concessions, and fundraising. Each Member of the Month is awarded a $10 Casey's gift card for their efforts to go above and beyond.
We plan to continue recognizing active team members at our annual banquet in April, but due to a galactic alien invasion, our orbit was cut short.
Besides our very own mission, SCFCCLA 2020, there are several other missions taking place on the district, state, and national levels.
One astronaut in particular decided to take her leadership skills to higher altitudes by serving as the Smith Center chapter president and the District B secretary. Along with the offices she held, she presented about the dangers of vaping on multiple different occasions to the community.
Another cadet, Sharon Topol, is serving as the Kansas State Vice President of Public Relations. Her cosmic leadership skills were strengthened even more when she attended the 2019 Capitol Leadership in Washington, D.C. last fall. Sharon also attended the Kansas Capitol Conference, where she met with the State Board of Education and had lunch with the Kansas State School Board representative.
Together, Sharon and JC combined their leadership skills as they traveled to Planet Russell to try and inspire them to form an FCCLA chapter. After sharing their information, they left Russell feeling well-informed on the purposes and benefits of FCCLA.
Throughout the school year, two peer ed astronauts have flown to three different planets to give presentations about financial fitness. No need for a telescope to see the extraordinary things our FCCLA members are doing.
Three members were so inspired by our leading astronauts that they decided to enter new galaxies of their own by interviewing to be district officers. They all landed among the stars when one was voted as a vice president of public relations, another as vice president of Power of One, and one as a state officer candidate.
Several members of our team fall into the FCS room black hole while working on speeches and creating display boards. Many members aspire to be like our great captains of the past. They brought one silver and two gold home to our native planet.
14 team members entered the abyss when they worked together to create 9 different star events. They made a difference in the galaxy and beyond and created awareness by presenting to civic organizations throughout the universe.
Our members formed a cosmic collaboration with Student Council and National Honor Society to develop the programs for the K through 6th graders for our annual Red Ribbon Week. They give interactive programs, and we even help them pledge to remain drug-free.
At a home basketball game in January, one Star Event group cooperatively worked with the cosmonauts of Phillips County to spread diabetes awareness. All basketball teams wore diabetes awareness shirts, and talks were given between the two games by two students that have type 1 diabetes. Over $500 was raised.
During September, the FCCLA leadership class stayed busy and got involved with preschool story time. They helped lead the story time by reading and planning activities. Another individualized mission was organized and carried out by our crew, who hosted a kindergarten Christmas party.
Our voyage gets more challenging as our team members are put to the test of community service. This is where we pushed our rockets to the max by encouraging active membership. Beginning in August, the Leadership Service in Action class has volunteered every Tuesday at the Hardly Used Shop. This continued throughout the whole year. The leadership class also gave monthly programs at rest homes, making crafts, playing games, and visiting with the residents. Our FCCLA chapter also volunteers to do Meals on Wheels for the elderly throughout the year.
In September, one Star Event was determined to make a difference on a planet many galaxies away. They purchased and made cakes to raffle off. Later on in the month, our amazing crew also helped with Old Settlers Day activities, which include providing nutritious snacks and carrying out a color run, which is known as the happiest 5K in the galaxy. We got involved with a longer half marathon race when we volunteered to bake muffins for the race to the center. We also served a meal for the Kiwanis annual meeting.
At a home football game, we decided to raise money for Chloe, a middle schooler from a neighboring community that had been in a serious boating accident. We sold caramel apples for Chloe to help her family cover medical expenses.
Zooming forward to October, a group of cadets served a hospital fundraiser to help raise money for our community's newly built hospital. This was followed by helping a Star Event participant with her stellar project by filling backpacks with hygiene products. These care bags were then sent to a small African village by Zambia. There was more help with this project as the leadership class put in multiple hours of helping prepare these bags throughout the school year. Members also served a meal at the monthly school board meeting to thank them for their support.
During the month of November, we traveled to the Galaxy of Giving and served a meal for our community chamber along with serving one for Western Plains. While at Western Plains, some members of the board gave their Star Event speeches. We also conversed with the residents and interacted with them by playing cards and board games. One Star Event in particular shot for the stars by hosting two sewing parties for their Dress a Girl project. These Saturday afternoons were spent cutting fabric, sewing, and designing skirts for girls in need.
December included serving a meal for the Western Plains Christmas, which was followed by serving another meal for an open house at one of the many local galactic banks. We also set up a Main Street Christmas kickoff event where our astronauts played games with the children and served out-of-this-world hot chocolate and cookies.
We then carried our service into the new year by serving a meal at an annual Quails Forever banquet. February brought serving walking tacos to 150 out-of-this-world junior high quiz bowl participants, celebrating FCCLA week and its 75th birthday, and holding a silent dessert option. auction to raise money for the annual FCCLA Alumni Scholarship. Within the next few months, we have planned several stellar community service projects. In the springtime, we had planned to work with FFA to do our annual Rake and Run event, clean up the yards through the galaxy, and participate in Do Good Friday, or whatever else might float into the atmosphere.
Mission SCFCCLA 2020 requires a big budget to fund our voyage. It is not easy to plan for service projects or rocket malfunctions along the way, but so far we are on track.
None of our missions would be possible without our fundraising efforts. Fundraising is a year-round project, and our FCCLA chapter has grown accustomed to raising money for our leadership conferences and our annual FCCLA scholarship.
Fundraising events include selling Little Caesars pizza kits, hosting soup suppers, working football and basketball concessions, and holding a silent dessert auction at a home game. We also sponsored food stands and food trucks at local events such as Old Settlers Day.
To add on to our fundraising tactics, we sold Virox, cinnamon rolls, and ham and cheese pockets. We also baked cookies for various businesses. Our efforts also included selling stadium seats, catering the food for the holiday open house at one of our local banks, and selling stainless steel Redmond cups. It really takes a lot of fuel to keep us out of the black hole.
Our mission orbited around state programs in action. The State Community Service Program, Skill Sharing, allows our astronauts to share their skills by doing programs, crafts, and activities at local rest homes and low-income housing facilities.
A national community service project was headed by Elise Meyer and Anna Long. Their project is called Why Should I Care? And they collected donations and raised funds to purchase and package 250 hygiene kits and wound care kits. They also collected canned food and bottled water that will be sent along with the kits to a small village in Zambia.
Financial Fitness peer education members Candace and JC carried out national program Financial Fitness by giving presentations and interactive workshops to FCCLA members in near and far galaxies. Financial Fitness Jeopardy was a big hit.
Something that has an impact on our school is a national student body project called Positive on Purpose. In this project, one student body member shares positive quotes over morning announcements every Friday, and she also encouraged students to leave positive notes in our school bathrooms.
National Project Lead to Feed has been maintained as an ongoing program in our school since 2016, when our FCCLA members wrote a grant and set up a school pantry. This pantry provides clothing, hygiene products, and food items to kids in need.
Mission SCFCCLA would not be successful without our Cosmic Promote and Publicize team. The Promote and Publicize team dedicated hours of their time to publicizing our activities and school events on several different medias. They dodged several asteroid showers by making sure flyers were posted, and they also promoted our projects on local radio stations, among many other medias. These efforts updated the public, shared activities, and spread FCCLA knowledge near and far through satellites on several planets.
Before we took off on our voyage, our Promote and Publicize team headed a special project at the county fair. They created and designed a booth to highlight past and present FCCLA officers and members. The booth was very informative and did a great job explaining FCCLA to the public, and also thanked the community for their support of our organization.
We believe our project addresses FCCLA Purpose 1, Number 4, and Number 6 to provide, with an emphasis on Number 6, which is to provide opportunities for making decisions and for assuming responsibilities. Captain, this is Control. Do you read me?
That's a copy, Control.
Captain, what is your evaluation of this mission?
Confirm. Approaching landing, I feel that our performance is right on schedule. We will adjust adequately by making adjustments to the reporting of member attendance and meetings in chapter events. This would give us a clearer picture of the participation in our galaxy.
Landing was successful. Mission SCFCCLA has been one small step for FCCLA and one giant leap for leadership.